What's up, divas? And what's up, divos? It's your girl, April. So, yes, it is Wednesday, and it is Real Talk Wednesday. So, it is time to spill the tea, talk some shit, and do what we do best. Talk some shit. So first of all, I know you girls probably, or not all of you guys, have probably looked on my Instagram or follow me on Instagram. If you don't, then please do so. It is in the information box below. But I do have a new addition to my family, which I will be doing a video with her. Just her. She is a new addition to my family. And if you don't know who I'm talking about, well, then you just have to go follow me on Snapchat. I'm really excited about it. And yes, I will be introducing you to her really, really soon. Also, if you're wondering about my hair, this is the exact same wig that I wore last Real Talk, which is the Vivica Fox Moncey wig. I just kind of like styled it different. I pulled it back a little bit because it is too damn hot. It's too damn hot for this, okay? It's too hot for anything. On the 4th of July, we went to this mall that I like it because it's kind of like dead. Out of 100, I'm going to say just out of 130 stores, there's probably like 40 stores or 50 stores that are open. The rest of them are closed or whatever. That's just giving you just like a kind of like ratio of what to look at when I'm looking at. Anyway, I like to go to this mall because I really don't like the crowded malls, but they have the store Rainbow in there. And if you girls have ever heard of Rainbow, which I'm pretty sure you have, it's really an inexpensive store for clothing for us ladies. And they also do sell children clothes now and shoes too. Whatever. This one is huge. And they have the plus size section, which I love. They have the hugest, like the biggest clearance sale going on right now. So I was able to get a lot of nice pieces for like $5, $3. So I will be sharing that with you girls in a lookbook really soon to come because, hey, I am all about affordability. A lot of people don't like really cheap clothing stores, but it doesn't have to do with the price. Sometimes you can buy something really expensive and it's made with cheap quality fabric. So it all depends. You just have to learn how to shop. So I will be doing a lookbook on that as well as, that's basically it. It's kind of early. I'm not going to be drinking anything. I really got to hurry up and do this video because I am going to be taking my grandson to Jubilee, which is kind of like for toddlers from 0 to 5 years old. And it's just basically an amusement type of indoor place for them to play. So I bought like a 5 or 10 admission pass from Groupon for him. And me and my daughter Tati are really excited about that. So I have to go get them so that we can go. But other than that, yeah, let's get on to this Real Talk. If you have a Real Talk that you want to be dished out, you can always send me an email to muffinismylovers2012@gmail.com. Please make sure to put in the subject line Real Talk so that I know it is an official Real Talk video. And yeah, if you want to change your characters' names, meaning if your name is Susan, but you don't want to be known as Susan, then let me know that in the video. This is your name for the video, etc., etc. So other than that, let's get on to this Real Talk. Okay guys, so I have three stories for you here, and let's get into this. Good evening, April, and I hope you had a good 4th of July. For name's sake, I will call myself Angela. I am happily engaged to my fiancé, Fletcher, and we are due to be married next year. I have two young children from a previous marriage, 6-year-old girl and a 4-year-old boy. He also has a son from a previous marriage, and he is 15 years old. We have been dating for 5 years, but moved in together for 2. Since we've lived together, his son has to stay with us for the summer. His ex-wife and son live in Florida, and we live in Michigan. Since his son has been staying with us during the summer, he has been picking on my son since he has 2 years. Oh, since his son has been staying with us during the summer, he has been picking on my son since he was 2 years old. He calls him gay or a crybaby. He has tried to ram my son's head into a wall while we wasn't looking, and tried to play it off as if my son tripped. I didn't see him do it, but I know he did, and at the same time, my son was not old enough to tell me what's wrong. He has told my daughter that she can't play ball with him because she is terrible, and it's her fault that everything is and always will be her fault, which made my daughter sad and upset. He has shot my son with a Nerf gun point blank in the shoulder, and my son told me, which he yelled, my son is a liar. I don't ever leave my kids with him while they are not in my eyesight. I don't trust him. Backstory, my fiance left his ex-wife because his wife didn't want to be with him. She used him to get military benefits and tried to clean out his 401k and savings account. So he left her and came to Michigan. His son was 8 years old when he left. I don't know what to do. I have expressed my feelings about what his son is doing and is capable of. I don't play when it comes to my babies. You hurt them, I will definitely hurt you. My fiance is stressed because he doesn't want to feel like he is choosing us over his son, because he feels like, bad enough, he is not there physically for his son, and he only can get him for the summer. I swear if I catch him or if my kids tell me that he is trying to hurt them physically or mentally, that he is no longer welcomed in my home. How could I tell someone that their child is not allowed to come to my home, but I have to protect my babies, which is more important? I would really appreciate your advice. Wow. So basically, Angela is engaged to Fletcher. They've been together for 5 years. They've been living together for two. Angela has two children, a 6-year-old daughter and a 4-year-old son. Fletcher has a 15-year-old son. Fletcher's son, we're just going to call him Eli. Eli comes to visit for the summer. Now, Eli is 15 years old. Why are you picking on a 4-year-old boy and a 6-year-old daughter, a little girl? There should be some boundaries. Is there something wrong with this little boy? I mean, he's 15, so he's a little boy to me. But we're not going to say he's a little boy to a 4-year-old. You know what I'm saying? You 15 years old. Why would you be picking on anybody's kids that is 4 years old and 6 years old? What is the problem? Seems like to me you are the most humongous bully on the face of the earth. Now, here's the thing. Let me catch you fucking with my kids. I don't care if you they age. Let me catch you fucking with one of my kids. It's going to be a holy hell problem. Because I have no issue of telling somebody's kids, listen, you can go get your mama or your father, whoever the fuck you want to go get. Because if you do anything else or say anything else to one of my kids, I'm going to fuck you up myself. I have no problem telling anybody's kids that. Because for one, you're not about to bully or pick on my children. And for two, don't show your ass. Because if you want to be a bully, a big bully, you 15 and you picking on a 4-year-old and a six-year-old, and you a bully, let me tell you something. Here I come. I'm going to bully your ass because I'm older than you and I'm bigger than you. Now, for one, your fiance shouldn't have a problem chastising his kid. He 15 years old. He a young man. He almost an adult. At 15 years old, you know right from wrong. How would he like it if somebody was picking on his little brother and his little sister and they were their age? You know what I'm saying? Now, either Fletcher going to grow some balls, or Fletcher's son is not going to be welcomed in my household no more. And you may have to think twice about marrying that motherfucker. Because for one, we come as a package deal. And if you can't respect and accept my children, then there is no reason for you to accept and respect me. That's just how I see it. Now, if you got a child with somebody else, by all means, I am more than happy to welcome them into my home and into our life and into my children's life. However, if your kid is going to be a dickhead, a straight-up douchebag, then it's going to be a problem, and I'm not going to welcome them into my household. I don't feel like anybody's children should be in harm's way or feel uncomfortable in their own home, no matter how limited a time it is. You know what I mean? And if Fletcher cannot grow some balls and say something to his son, then there is a problem with Fletcher, and maybe he is not the right man for you. Now, 5 years to some is a long time. That is a minute to be with somebody. However, there is a thin line between love and hate and children. I'm not going to let you bully my children, okay? I am not going to let you mistreat my children. I don't give a damn who you are. You could be God yourself or anybody greater than. You are not about to bully my children or anybody else's kids. You cannot come up in here and start some shit. So here's the thing. Fletcher already had an issue. He left his wife because she used him for his military benefits and she tried to drain his 401k. So he left her and he moved to Michigan. Bravo, bravo. But don't feel bad because you left her when your son was 8 years old. Things gotta be done. Shit is the way it is. Some shit happens for a reason. But you're not gonna allow your child to come here to my home, to our home, and bully our children. If Fletcher is not saying anything about this to his son, Eli, then of course he's going to continue to do it. Now, if you're supposed to be a military man, then you should have some standards, okay? You should have some standards and you should have some values. Because I heard, I don't know personally, but I've heard that many military men and women have different moral standards. They are a lot stricter with their children and they are more stand-up type of people from what I have heard and been told, okay? However, we all bleed the same and we have all the same skin, okay? It may be a different shade, but we are all human beings and that is the bottom line. Bullying comes in all shapes and forms. And here you are, 15 years old. You are 11 years older than a 4-year-old and you want to bully them. That is a huge sign, a form of bullying. Maybe Fletcher's son, Eli, is being bullied in his own hometown. And this is what he does. Either he ain't got no home training, and it seems like he doesn't have any home training because the only time that Fletcher sees him is during the summer months. So all the other 10 months of the year, he's with his mother. And obviously, if he's doing this when he comes there, then he's doing this when he's back at home. Now, he feels bad. Fletcher feels bad. Okay, that's great. You feel bad that you aren't a father all year round, but you are a father. You just ain't there. You can't put your emotions sometimes into what is a moral value in disciplining a child. If that's the case, my kids would be running amok. I have 5 children. I would be letting them terrorize everybody because I feel like my emotions. My children have never, ever been bullies to anybody, okay? Never. I don't play that shit. I have been bullied and picked on during my school year, all my school year life, for the littlest things, from the little plaits, the braids all in my hair that my mother would put with like 16 little ponytails, to my freckles, to my skin color, to my mother buying me shoes that weren't Adidas. They had 4 stripes and they were called balloons, to all type of things. So I know how it is to be bullied and to be picked on. And I refuse to allow anybody in my family to be picked on, and I refuse for my children to pick on anybody. That's just a form of hate, disrespect, okay? Disrespect. So you're either going to have to sit down and let Fletcher know, listen, your son is really making my children feel uncomfortable. And this is not good and healthy for our relationship. My children should not have to feel like for the summer month that they are being bullied and mistreated. They're little kids. These are babies compared to a 15-year-old. My daughter is 8 years old. My mumsy is 8 years old. And like I said, I have 5 children. Now my mumsy is 8 years old. And I felt like it was a form of bullying when my ex, not my ex-husband, my ex-boyfriend, went on Facebook that I had to look through his tablet after I had him arrested, talking about my 8-year-old mumsy, talking about how she's overweight and shit like that, talking about her to unknown females. Like, to me, that's a form of disrespect and that's a form of bullying. And I'd be damned if anybody, I don't give a damn if it's on social media, in person, family member. You ain't about to sit here or any place, any given day, and talk about any one of my children, regardless if they are overweight or if their hair may be a little bit coarse. I've had people say things on YouTube. Oh, well, her daughter's hair is, she don't do her daughter's hairs like that. I don't think I need to put a wig on my fucking kids, okay? They get extension braids put in their hair because their hair is more coarser and it allows their hair to grow. So I don't think I should put a wig on my daughters who are 8 and 14. I mean, let's be realistic here, okay? Nor should I have to put a weave in their hair. But either way, to me, it's a form of bullying and disrespect. So what you really need to do, my dear, you really need to have a nice, long sit-down with Fletcher, Angela, and let him know if your son continues his misbehavior towards my children, which is a sign of abuse, I'm not going to welcome him here for the summer months. I'm sorry. There have been kids that have killed other kids, okay, and have been put in jail. You guys know what I'm talking about. You have seen 12-year-olds that have beat 2-year-olds to death. And it's been all over the news. It's nothing recent, but it has happened within the past few years. A 13-year-old has killed a 2-year-old. A 12-year-old has killed a 4-year-old. All types of shit. So we're not going to let this situation get out of hand. Now, either Fletcher talks to his son, or maybe you should have a good old talk with Fletcher's baby's mother, his ex-wife, and let her know that the things that her son is coming there and doing. Maybe she does not allow that. However, being that her son is being sent away for the summer, maybe Fletcher is allowing it because he feels so bad. So maybe you should speak to the source where the young man resides at most of the year. Maybe she doesn't allow that, but being that he comes there for the summer and he sees that his father is so lenient and just carefree, he does what he wants. But at home, he doesn't. And sometimes that's how kids act out, because one of their parents is so strict, or just a different household is so strict. When they come somewhere else, they go to somebody else's house, it's a total difference. Or they go to school, it's a total difference. You know what I mean? Like, I've had issues like that with my daughter, Tatiana, because my household, I'm so strict, and I don't play that shit. When she would go to school, she would act out and do all type of things, be a little loosey-goosey at the mouth with the teachers. So shit happens like that. So maybe you should speak to the source, because Fletcher, since he feels so fucking bad, maybe you should go to his ex-wife and speak to her about it. But first, I would try to speak to Fletcher about it. And if he doesn't do anything and you don't see any change or anything being done, then I would definitely go to the main source and have a conversation with her. It's not a disrespect. It's not out of disrespect for Fletcher, but you have children in your household. And I'm pretty sure that this woman, as a mother, would not appreciate her 15-year-old picking on anybody's children. We as women have a more sympathetic nature, a more nurturing nature than men. You know what I'm saying? So I would definitely speak to the mother if Fletcher is not doing anything about this. And that's just my take on it. So ladies, yes, let Angela know, what would you do in the fact or in the case if your kids were being picked on by a boyfriend or fiance or husband's child that comes and hangs out for the summer or whenever, you know what I'm saying? What would you do if anybody was picking on your kids? You know what I'm saying? Me personally, it's gonna be a motherfucking problem. On some real shit, it's gonna be some shit popping off. I'm just saying, you know what I'm saying? So next story. Hello, I need some advice. I feel real stupid right now, but I'm hurt. My boyfriend broke up with me. He is 28 and I'm 36. Hello. He just broke up with me talking about I'm not a godly woman. We were together for 4 months, but I was good enough to lay with. Meet his parents, brother, and sister-in-law, and even go to his church. Help me with his business as well. I feel betrayed. No, I don't attend church regularly. Actually, I just moved to this area months ago, and I haven't been to church except with him. I don't understand why he didn't want to build with me. To him, it's acceptable for a woman to go to church seeking a man when she's supposed to be there seeking God. To him, at least she is in church. Even though I have a good heart, just spiritually immature, I guess you could put it that way. I'm not good enough. What's so killing? He was mad when I packed up his stuff. No, he didn't live here, but he was over here enough. Took my keys back, unfriended him on Facebook, and told him we can't be friends. What's sad is my old dumb ass wants him back, but somehow he set in his mind this is right. And this came all of a sudden. We had plans to be together 4th of July weekend. It's like he had a talk with someone that influenced his decision. He even claimed he loved me and don't want to break up. He even claimed he loved me and he didn't want to break up. I forgot to add, I'm so dumb, I even called myself trying to fix it or see if we can work it out. And he said this isn't fixable because we have different standards and values, which is incorrect. We want the same things, but he don't see that. We even had a conversation about child support. No, I'm not pregnant, but he doesn't believe in it. And we have had an argument about that. He is a really good guy, or was he playing me all along? Okay, so this is kind of a little bit all over the place. We're going to just call her Goddess. We're going to call her a Goddess. First of all, so Goddess is 36 years old, and her 28-year-old boyfriend broke up with them after 4 months. He said that she wasn't godly enough. She wasn't a godly woman enough. However, he had no issues coming to her home, leaving his shit over there, laying up with her, bringing her to church, introducing her to his family and friends, and help and having her assist him with his business. Okay? But now, all of a sudden, she feels like she's been betrayed because he just feels like they don't have the same aspects, they don't have the same values, they don't have the same issues. and etc., etc., okay? So she unfriended him on Facebook, packed his shit up, got her keys back. First of all, y'all been together. You 36 years old, goddess. This fool is 28. You are 8 years older than him, okay, for one, which is not a bad thing, but y'all have been dating each other for 4 months. I'm sorry, but where in 4 months do you give somebody your key at? I'm just saying, we ain't been together long enough for you to be leaving your shit all over my motherfucking house or have a key to my house. Now, it's one thing to go to church. You know what? Here's the thing. I don't go to church like everybody else does. There's a lot of hypocrites in church. So that is one reason why I don't go to church, and that's just me. I'm not saying that everybody has to follow behind what I'm doing, but I do have a faith and I do believe in God. I just don't follow it like everybody else by feeling like, okay, I'm gonna go to church today and then tomorrow I'm gonna act up, or I'm gonna be good all week and then on a weekend or whatever fucking day I feel like acting up and being sinful, I'm gonna do that. But on Sunday, I'm gonna go in there, I'm gonna go to church and I'm gonna pay my tithes and etc. etc. I rather believe in my own faith, and I have my own faith and my own belief, and that's me, okay? I'm not saying for anybody to follow in what I do. However, my personal preference is if I meet someone who is so godly and is just very heavily in religion and church and things of that nature, I'm probably not going to be interested in you, because I really don't feel like you're going to force me into doing something that I don't want to do, and I feel like, okay, this is my life, I'm going to do what I feel like doing. You know what I'm saying? That's just me. However, y'all are 8 years apart, y'all been together for 4 months, and now all of a sudden he don't find you interesting. Y'all don't have the same values, y'all don't share the same values, and he broke up with you. Let me tell you something. First of all, 4 months ain't a long time to be in a relationship at all, for you to be heartbroken, stressed out, depressed, or what have you. Don't feel stupid. Some of us fall in love a little bit too fast. However, 4 months, you still in the getting to know you period, okay? People come into relationships with all type of shady shit and all kind of motives and hidden agendas, and you meet somebody's representative in the very beginning of a relationship. And yes, indeed, he still got his representative going on at 4 months old, okay? At 4 months, your relationship is not a relationship. It's still basically a dating relationship. I can't tell you that I love you after 4 months. I may love the things that you do, like make me laugh and shit like that, but I can't really personally say that I really fucking love you. However, you cannot stop your heart from wanting what it wants. But let me tell you something. If you feel that I'm so fucking ungodly, then nigga, what the fuck are you if you constantly up in my ungodly pussy and ungodly household, all right, that you feel like you so better than thou, okay? So if he wants to call you ungodly, what the fuck is he? This is what I'm talking about hypocrites, okay? So you go to church every Sunday, but then Monday through Saturday, you laying up in my motherfucking pussy in house with your ungodly ass. If you are so godly, then you shouldn't be laying up in my house and fucking me and leaving your shit over in my house. You should be courting me and dating me and not getting no motherfucking ass, because you are so better than me and so godly. So if he wants to be a hypocrite and call you ungodly, then this must be Satan's motherfucking keeper right here, sitting up in God's house swearing that you ain't a woman of God and you need to not come to church. Now, for one thing, I don't really appreciate when people say, you know what? You looking for a man? Go to church. Bitch, what make you think that I need a man that's so godly? Just because he go to church don't mean that I want his motherfucking monkey ass. Maybe he ain't really godly and he's sitting up here looking for women that he can use because he feels they are so naive and vulnerable because they looking for a man. I'm sorry, but I'm not the type of bitch who gonna go to church looking for a man. Because just because his ass sit up in motherfucking church don't make him so godly and better than anybody else and a goddamn saint. Okay, so people, please stop saying, if you're looking for a good man, you should go to the house of the Lord. The only good man that's in the house of the Lord is the Lord himself. I'm sorry, but the preacher, the pastor, the father, what makes you feel like he's so holier than thou? I'm not trying to preach to y'all or put anybody's religion down, but a preacher, a pastor, and a father, and a reverend, that is their job. They get paid for doing their services. Whether you think so or not, how the fuck do y'all think they afford that car and that house and them nice clothes and whatever else they got going on? That is their job, okay? They do go on interviews and they have to perform. They get a paycheck too, okay? So don't feel like they are so godly because they are in the house of the Lord. Now, for one, Let's just take it back to he said you weren't so godly. Well, you know what, motherfucker? After 4 months, and you ain't so godly neither. Because you showed your fucking devilish ass by bringing me to church and fucking me Monday through Saturday. And then here you are. You decide that you didn't want to fuck with me no more. No, let's see. It's not because you so god, you so not godly. Okay, goddess. It's because he found some younger pussy on the side, maybe from his church, that he's more interested in. Okay, that he could swindle and con. Unlike you, who is 36 years old, you are a little bit more mature than him, and maybe he wasn't getting over like he wanted to. So therefore, he found someone that is more or less his age or underneath his age that probably go to his church that he can fucking mold, shape, and have her do whatever the fuck ungodly things that he wants to do. So it's not because you're ungodly. It's because he found some younger pussy and stupid pussy, a more dumber pussy on the side. So don't feel like you stupid. Now here's the thing. The motherfucker don't believe in child support. I wonder why. Let's see. Does he have a kid that you don't fucking know about and his ass don't pay child support? Because if you're so godly and you believe in faith and you believe that the Lord should help everybody and that we should all be treated equally and et cetera, et cetera, then you should believe in some motherfucking child support. If you are a man that don't believe in child support, then there is a serious issue with you. And maybe it's because your broke, dumb ass, devilish, sinful ass got a kid somewhere that we don't know about. And you don't pay child support, or you do pay child support, and you're paying child support because you are being forced to pay child support, meaning they garnish it from your wages because your godly ass can't afford, or just your godly ass don't want to give it on your own, so your baby mother then took you to court and now they garnish it from your wages. I don't see how anybody could not believe in child support. Now here's my thing. I believe in child support, but this is what I don't believe in. I don't believe that I should have to go to fucking court and drag your fucking dumb, naive ass into court and force you to give our child money to take care of, okay? I don't believe that. If I have to go through all of that because of your dumb shit, then you know what? I don't even want it. Okay, I'm not gonna put myself through a whole bunch of shit be forcing you to do anything. But I believe that you should give money. I believe that you should take care of your kids. I believe that there's child support. But I don't believe that I should have to fucking force you at the hands of the law to take your money from you when you are the one that made this child with your dick and you don't want to help take care of it. That's the fucking worst. When a woman has to go to child support and force their significant other or their ex to pay for their child. You should want to give money and take care of your child willingly, okay? Now back to the ungodly shit. You know what, goddess? If you so ungodly, then you know something, move on. Stop trying to fix some shit that ain't even fucking broken. This nigga done found some young pussy and some godly, ungodly pussy from the church. Like I said, your ass ain't the ungodly one. It's him. He was down with fucking you. He was down with leaving his shit at your house, okay? The cover-up was to introduce you to his family. That's nice, but if you're so godly and you believe in God so much, then your ass should not be sitting up in my house all the fucking time and using my fucking electricity, water, food, have keys to my apartment, and be having your shit over there. Because that's not godly if we're not married. Point blank, period. And after 4 months, it's not really a considered a relationship. So I'm sorry that you've been hurt, you know what I'm saying? But you know what? It's only 4 months. Get over it and move the fuck on. And don't worry about finding a man in church. The right man will eventually come along. Let me tell you something. Because if they were really good men out there, don't you think a bitch like me would have went to church already? Because I have had my share in relationships. I have been married and divorced. I have just recently broken up with somebody. So if there were really good men in church and I really believed in that, don't you think that us bitches that don't have a good man, we all be at the fucking church? There wouldn't be no room. There would be lines outside each and every fucking church out there like, okay, take a number because that's when your ass get to go in. I'm just looking for the right man. You don't go to church to look for the perfect man. You go to church for your faith and belief. If one so happens to come along, then one so happens to come along. But bitches, don't think just because you go to church that that's where you're gonna find the godly one at, okay? Because that godly one will be the one to hurry up and quickly tell your ass, ooh, sugar, pie, honey, bunch. Ooh, what you doing here? You looking so good. Just wanna take you out on a date. Nigga, wasn't you just saying hallelujah and amen? and you was just at the pulpit crying your eyes out and had the Holy Ghost. Now you're talking about, ooh, sugar, honey, brown skin, iced tea, you look so good, I want to take you out on a date. What the fuck? I'm just saying. The people that you see go up in church is not the people you see Monday through Saturday all the fucking time. Now, we have those that are holy rollers, okay? Those, and I'm just sorry to say that. So, for those of you who get offended because you are so godly, I'm sorry, but we are all entitled to our motherfucking opinions here, okay? And I'm not a holy roller. And a holy roller is one of those who is constantly preaching to you about some shit. Constantly preaching, 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 preaching. But they don't have their shit together, okay? Those are the holy rollers. And here's my thing. Stop forcing your belief on everybody, okay? Stop it. I've had people that have different religions knock on my door several times, okay? And I have been very, very humble and respectable. No thank you, no thank you. And then after the eighth time, when I say, can you please, that's not my faith or belief, so would you please not come back to my door? Don't have your next group of people knocking on my door. This is what I've had happen to me. And I had to actually go off on them. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to say what religion this is, but okay, thank you. I'm going to take your brochure and I appreciate it. Because I'm a very respectable person and I believe that everybody has their right to feel how they feel about any type of religion or faith. But I would appreciate it if you don't try to force it on me and don't keep coming knocking on my door. Just don't keep preaching it to me. Well, can we come in and talk? No! First of all, that's great that this is your religion and this is your belief, but I don't even know you. Just because you're preaching this to me does not mean I should welcome you into my home, okay? I don't know what you're capable of doing. You know what I'm saying? So, people, just because you believe in one thing doesn't mean that you have to force it on the other person. And for those of you who are those holy rollers and are getting offended with what I'm saying, well, you know what? I'm not going to apologize for it, but I'm going to just say this. I'm sorry you feel that way. It's not really an apology, but it's, oh, I'm sorry you feel that way. You know what I'm saying? But don't feel like, okay, goddess, you got to go to church and find somebody, a real man, and this is what he's saying to you. You know what I'm saying? Real woman. Man, listen. If you're going to church to find a man or you're going to church to find a woman, then you are ungodly and your ass don't need to be sitting up there, okay? There should be like some type of holy water that's on the floor so people that are just really hypocrites and sinful, they just get, start smoking up and they just can't get in. You know what I'm saying? The fake ass people. The fake people. That's just my take. So let Goddess know what you feel about this herb ass ungodly Negro who feels like she wasn't godly enough and good enough and ain't shared enough values. They shared some shit together. It was the sweat in between them motherfucking sheets. That's for sure. It was the sweat in between them goddamn sheets. And he didn't have a problem with that. All right, ladies, so this is the last one. This is going to be quite long. Not quite long, but somewhat long. Hey, April, I love your videos and your honesty, and I have been watching your videos since 2011. I'm changing my name to Renee. Get your drinks, because it's a long one. When I was 13, my mother started dating this man whom she kept in the dark for about a year. So after a year, I met him once, and I was in my mother's room one day. I had just recently turned 14 at this time. I couldn't help but notice a man's clothing in her room, pushed into a closet. I asked her, are those his clothes, referring to her boyfriend? And she said yes. And I said, is he moving in? And she replied yes. Now, April, remind you, I only met him once, so he finally moves in and I'm uncomfortable because she works night shifts and I don't want to be there with him. And I tell my mother this because I only met him once and my siblings were grown in their mid-20s. Fast forward to a year later, I'm 15. My mother goes to work at 8 p.m. and around this time I had did something in school, so I was on punishment. So she took the phones and Wi-Fi box, literally. So I'm watching some cartoons on TV in our family room, and her boyfriend is in the kitchen drinking an 18-pack of beers. And I remember because my mom had just bought them for him, and he drank over half of them. So I'm watching my cartoon, and this motherfucker comes in there to where I was and forces himself onto me. Now, I'm fighting for dear life. He raises my gown up and is touching me like no young girl should be touched. He pulls his pants down. All along, I'm screaming bloody murder. So he releases me and goes into my mother's room as if nothing happened. So I walk to the police station and my siblings come to get me because my mother wasn't answering her cell phone. So the police goes to my house only to find him not there and find beer bottles in our trash. So fast forward, my mother comes home to me and my three older siblings sleep, and she is yelling, "Why am I not at school?" wondering why they were there. So we tell her that the police are looking for him and that child services is coming by. She flips out and yells, "He can go to jail. He can go to jail and never see his children. Meanwhile, I've just been molested and almost raped by your boyfriend." So she kicks me out and tells my siblings, "Take the little bitch with you," and puts all of my belongings in a contractor trash bag. So here I am living with my siblings for 1 month. And to remind you, after DCF told her, which is the Department of Children's Facility, I think, that he can't come near me until 18 years of age. She makes me go to my oldest brother's house every night because she has to work night shifts, only to me and my big sister finding out that she has been at home at night with him, because one night she said she was at work, so me and my sister went to the house to get something, only to find both of their vehicles there. Now, we didn't go in, we just kept going, we just kept going by. So fast forward, he has his own place that my mother told me. So it's almost 2 years later. Okay, so he finally has his own place, my mother tells me. It's almost 2 years later, and my mother comes to tell me that they're married. When all along I thought she was done with him for what he had done to me, but April, I was wrong. After building our new house, she moved him back in a couple months before my 18th birthday. So in response to me feeling lost, I started dating this boy at my school at the age of 14, and I knew he wasn't the type of person that I should have talked to. But being young, I did so. I lost my virginity to him. At 16, I graduated high school, and this motherfucker didn't. He dropped out of senior year, so I'm prepping to go off to college, only to find out that I'm 3 months pregnant, along with still getting a menstrual cycle. So now I've decided to move with my dad and to go to college locally, which my dad's idea for me to go to school with my dad pay my tuition. So I won't have debt along with me not getting a job, because my dad believed that my job is college, and his granddaughter, PSA, my dad was my primary caregiver, meaning financially my mother had no worries. Literally, being my dad's only child, I was a daddy's girl. Fast forward again to me having my daughter, and I'm in college, and my daughter's dad and I were still together, and he is a good father, but to me, finding out that he was cheating when getting my annual pap, only to find out that I have an STD. Yes, I was cured and checked twice because of fear to assure it was gone. Never to me sleeping with anyone else besides my daughter's father. I confront him, and he says, while folding his damn arms, "I didn't do it." Continues to ask me who I've been sleeping with, and blackened with. I had blackened his eye before I knew it, being a person against violence. So he finally admits he did sleep with three other females, which I didn't need his confessions because it was in my pap results. Only to find that he was talking to an 18-year-old girl on Facebook. Remind you, we are 21 and 22, him being 22, and his chick knew he had an STD. No, this motherfucker didn't get cured until 4 months later. Me knowing that, he thought him getting cured was going to get us back together by showing me doctor's documentations of test results. So fast forward 6 months later, my father passes a massive heart attack. I'm in distress because I don't want to move with my mother and her molestating, raping husband, whom he has had over 20 affairs on her. I'm open public. P.S. He left her last year because he didn't like the fact of me and my daughter here at my mother's house, so I moved in so I could finish school, which I'll be done in October of this year. So my mom still continues to talk to him after she knows that what he has done to me and left her. April, I finally tell my mom how I felt about him, and of course she acts like she doesn't care and doesn't give two shits, not to mention that she's told me she didn't believe me and that he even did that to me. So here I am at crossroads after being molested, to my daughter's father giving me an STD, to my father dying, to me just finding out I have stage 3 cervical cancer. And instead of my mother being a mother, she's chasing her devil ass boyfriend, or husband rather, so-called, instead of worrying about me, her daughter, her baby being diagnosed with cancer. She isn't, by the way, my mother. She has been a nurse for 17 years. I don't talk to my, what? With cancer. Okay. I don't talk to my child's father anymore after 8 years, but I do let him see our daughter, whom just turned 5 this year. And it's for me and my mom. I'm seriously leaving the state and moving away because my soul is shot. She just says it happened to me. So live, so you'll live. Yes, those were her exact words. April, please respond. I know it's a mouthful, but I need help. Everyone just acts as if this was shit is normal. Okay, so first of all, Renee's mother, okay, because it was kind of like all over the place. So Renee's mother was dating a guy she met once. Her mother moved the guy in. Renee is 15 years old. Her mom works nights. Her mom's boyfriend is a drunk, because if you can drink a 16-pack of beer and get drunk and then go in there and force yourself on a 15-year-old daughter, you're a drunk and a pedophile, okay? Renee tells her mother, all she cares about is basically that, oh my God, you called the police on him. He's going to go to jail. He's never going to see his own children again, et cetera, et cetera. She doesn't answer her phone. Renee has to call her siblings who are older. She has to go to the police station. Her mother kicks her out, makes her go live with her siblings because she's mad that she called the police on her boyfriend. Renee ends up going to college. Renee ends up pregnant. Renee ends up living with her father. Renee's father ends up passing away. First of all, let's just keep the story on Renee's mother, okay? Because baby drama always happens all the time. Yes, baby's father's cheap, and that's the thing. However, Renee has a serious issue with her own mother. Now, here's the thing, Renee. You are a grown-ass woman now. You don't have to stay with her if you don't want to. Me personally, I wouldn't even want my child, my daughter, around her, because if she could care less about you, I can only imagine how she cares about your daughter. And if it were my child and something happened to my daughters that one of my boyfriends, or not one of my, but a boyfriend or a husband did to one of my daughters, thank God it hasn't, but oh my God, a bitch would be in handcuffs, all right? I would be in jail. I would get out, hopefully, but a bitch would be in handcuffs and in jail, and all y'all motherfuckers would have to bail me out and put money on my commissary or books, because I would to kill that motherfucker. And it's crazy because as a woman, you know, when my daughter Tati got older, you know, I was still married, and she started developing. Of course, I knew in my heart, and I would hope to think that, okay, my husband doesn't look at her that way. But you can always, because he wasn't his daughter, but you always have to think that way, okay? You always have to stop and think that way. I'm not saying you always have to, but if you are with somebody and your child is developing, you, and they look womanly, you don't never know what goes on in anybody's mind. I'm just saying. You never know what goes on in anybody's mind. Even their own father can do things like that to them, okay? I've seen many stories on the news and those crime TV shows where fathers do things like that to their own daughters. And it's just so disturbing. And as a woman, you know, you don't want to think that way, but you have to put your mind state in that kind of thought, because anything is capable to happen to your daughter. People have all kind of thoughts in their head. You can never read anybody's mind. And I'm sorry, but I'm not going to move in my new boyfriend that I just met with my daughter, who she's only met him one time. What's wrong with him living on his own? And it's sad because I never thought that women would just take their boyfriend or their husband's side after finding out that their child was molested by them. Like, when I've seen things on TVs and movies and shows, like, your child goes to you and says to you, he molested me, he touched me, and the woman doesn't believe it. Like, why wouldn't you believe anything like that? Like, I'm sorry, but if my kid came to me and said something like that, I would definitely believe them, because I wouldn't think that a child would want to make something up like that. Like, that is the worst thing to make up. And even if they did make it up and you find out later on in the long run, I still would believe them when they first told me. And I would just constantly believe them. Like, I would never, like, second guess, like, you're telling me a lie? Like, I would never, ever second guess that. I would definitely, definitely believe that. It's, when women don't believe shit like that, that their child has come and told them about their husband or their boyfriend, then that means that there's something really wrong with them as a woman. I'm sorry, but if you are to come to me and say, oh, your boyfriend molested me, or oh, daddy molested me, and I didn't believe you, then, and or I went off on you, then there's something wrong with me. Because if you cannot listen to your child and tell your child right from wrong, and let your child know, you know what, I'm on your side, and it's going to be okay, and you're safe, then there's definitely something wrong with you as a person. And me personally, if that were me, I definitely would not want to deal with that person as a mother. If that was my mom, I just couldn't deal with her. If you're going to choose your boyfriend and then you're going to marry him over me, your child, then there's definitely something wrong with you. We are blood. I'm your child. We're going to be together for the rest of our lives. This motherfucker, men come and go. Women come and go. It's no guarantee that you're going to be here tomorrow in my life, but you're my child, and it's no guarantee that you're going to be here tomorrow in my life. Something may happen to you or me, but for the time being, I want to cherish every moment that I have. So I would never put a man before any of my children, let alone believe him over you. You know what I'm saying? I always believe my kids over anybody that I've been in a relationship with, because these are my children. And whether I find out that they don't like you and they've done this because they don't like you, that's one thing. But if any of my children have to come to me and said anything about anybody that I've been with, then best believe we're going to handle this, and best believe it's going to be a situation. Okay, just definitely going to be a situation. Just like with my daughter Nay, she went on my laptop before I got her laptop, and she said, you know what, I think Jamel, my ex-boyfriend, be going on these dating sites. And I was like, what are you talking about? She was like, because all these kind of like dating sites and all kind of porn keep popping up. And I looked in the history and there it goes. So I said something to him about it. I didn't say who told me. I said something to him about it. You know what he said? Oh, that's probably our son. My son only goes on that computer to do homework. He don't be looking at that type of shit. And I believed my daughter. And I said something to him about it again. And he tried to say it wasn't him. So it was an issue. It was an issue for a long time. Kind of find out she was right, and I believed her the whole entire time. He just tried to point the blame on my son, who's 18 or 17 at the time. So you trying to take your blame and point on somebody else. That's a real cowardly move. Like, really? That's like some real cowardly shit. What? You know, when a kid comes to you and says anything about something that somebody is doing to them or doing to you, you should really take heed to it, because 9 times out of 10, kids just don't make shit up like that. And if you are a parent, you always have to give your kids the benefit of the doubt, and you always supposed to support them. So me personally, honey, I would definitely move away. You got cervical cancer, which I do believe. I'm not really sure. I'm not a doctor. But let me tell you something. You got your 5-year-old daughter. You got yourself. And you got friends and other family members. If your mother doesn't want to be respectable to you and your child, and she want to go ahead with that motherfucker, then go ahead. Let her go ahead. You got your other siblings that I know can care about you. I'm pretty sure, because they were there for you since the day one, and they'll continue to be there. But I definitely wouldn't deal with her, and I wouldn't bother with her. One day, hopefully, she'll come around, and she'll realize her wrongdoings. Hopefully, it's not too late. But until then, I would not deal with that type of shit. Don't put your little daughter in a situation where she's uncomfortable. And don't put yourself in any more situations where you're uncomfortable. As for your baby father, he's a jackass. Just continue to let him visit his daughter and see his daughter. But for being in a relationship with him and giving you an STD, you know, some of the best of us have caught STDs from cheating boyfriends, okay? We have, and we have gotten over it. But you know something? Don't give that motherfucker another chance, because once a dirty dick, always a dirty dick. You know what I'm saying? An STD can make you infertile, can make you depressed, can make you do all kinds of things. You know what I'm saying? It is not a good feeling to have an STD. But I'm gonna tell you what, we can get over and get past it and get cured. However, I'm not about to give your dirty dick another chance. Once a dirty dick, always a dirty dick. Sometimes we gotta leave people alone in life to make our own selves flourish and to gain our own respect and to love ourselves. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes we gotta just do that. And I've decided to do that myself. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's just me and my kids, and I'm good with that. That whole dating shit on Match.com, it was cool. I tried it out once, and I did try the OkCupid that some other people had told me to try out. Let me tell you, there are some weirdos out there. It's funny to be able to chat to them, but you ain't about to send me pictures, or your whole profile picture is nothing but close-ups of your dick. You can't per se see the dick flesh, but you can see it through the pants. And then you want to start sending me messages, and then at the end of the conversation, I'm like, listen, if you're trying to find somebody on here, you really need to think about your profile pictures, because they really don't look like it. Well, okay, are you up for fucking? Listen, let me tell you something, bitches. These dating websites, Match.com, OkCupid, I never even heard of OkCupid until my last video. These motherfuckers is real thirsty out there, okay? And I'm sorry, but I'm just not up for all of that. I mean, I have some really weird messages and all kind of shit, and I'm gonna share that with y'all on the next video. So if y'all want to see on the next Real Talk, you like me to share my experiences with you guys from just messages with these people, then let me know, because I would be more than happy to. You know, there are some weird motherfuckers out there, and a bitch be having to block a whole bunch of them, okay, or disable her motherfucking content. You know what I'm saying? But yes, sweetheart, Renee, leave them alone, because life is too short to be miserable, even with your own parents. You know what I'm saying? Unfortunately, even with our own parents, we have to leave them alone at times. You know, I'm not about to kiss your ass because you're my mother or my father. I got kids of my own to take care of. And if you can't respect me as a person, then you know what? I guess it's just best left alone. I want my kids to be happy. Why the fuck do you think I moved all the way to the other side of the country, y'all? Okay? I ain't got no family over here but my kids. No family over here but my kids. And the only one that checks on me and my kids is my father. So go figure. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you got to do shit for yourself and not do shit to make other people happy. And that's just the bottom line. So on that note, let these ladies know what you think and your basic opinions and your opinions and all. And if you want me to do another Real Talk about the dating online shit, then let me know in the comments below. And so on that note, stay diva and divalicious, and I'll check you girls out on the next video.